When he said to me, "You don't deserve a boyfriend," I started thinking about the people who do. Incarcerated serial killers have really prolific love lives, mostly through written correspondence, sometimes culminating in visitation marriage ceremonies and commissary deposits. I thought about pimps who love with closed fists and their devoted bottom bitches sticking their cheeks out, both sets. The scumbags who get drunk on the corner and piss behind my house so I have to see them with their flies unzipped every time I take out my garbage. Women who leave their kids in the car. Women with crow's feet and grooved mouths looking to suck on more than just cigarettes at the closest tavern, low breasts on the wood bar, leaning into everything he says, hoping for another drink. Women who lie. Women who look for monsters under the sheets. Women who twist a pocket knife in your heart because someone put one in theirs long ago. Women who are haunted. I thought about that guy I took home who had a girlfriend and how frank he was when I said, "How many times have you done this?" And he said three, but he didn't know why, because he loved her. I thought about my mother's lifelong collection of $2 bills and how amused my father's dope dealer must have been when he handed them over. I thought about me, made a list of everything rotten in my heart, which I can do lightning fast because no one keeps a better inventory than I do, and I know exactly where to find it. "I'm just telling it like it is," he said. "You need to hear this shit." And I don't, actually, because I know it already, and I'm wrong about it too.